Okay, so let's continue with another example. So in this experiment, we have two different treatment methods, and we want to see which treatment is better than the other one. So we have two treatments, A and B. Okay, so we want to compare these on six patients. Okay, and we have treatment A. And we want to say that treatment A is better in first 5 patients, and treatment and B in only the 6th one. Okay, so we have this experiment. We know that treatment A is better in the first 5 patients, and B is only on the 6th patient. Okay, so let's do the setup of this experiment, understand what type of distribution that I have to select, and which distribution to choose, and which parameter is my parameter of interest. So let's imagine this experiment was conducted. So think about that, actually, how you will conduct and how you will treat, which treatment is better, which setup do we use. Okay, so you want to consider it as a number of patients is better, which treatment type, or so what type of treatment or design of experiment do you want to use to solve this problem? Which one is better? And mathematically or statistically, you want to prove that treatment A is better than treatment B. Let's imagine this experiment was conducted by two statisticians, let's say, that each of whom not know the other one doing. The others had a different study design in mind. Okay, so what type of things do you consider? So here we have two investigators. Their approaches is totally different than each other. But let's see their results about the parameter will be the same or not. The proportion of patients getting better in treatment A or B. So first investigators consider this problem as we have a fixed number of patients planned study at the beginning, so with 6 patients, and then we are counting how many of the patients are getting better under which treatment. So here think about the binomial setup. Okay, so he considered this problem as a binomial experiment and tried to find the proportion of getting better in treatment A or treatment B as the parameter that we want to find. Okay, in the second investigator's approach, he used a different setup. And in this setup, he said that the experiment is planned to stop the study when the first patient who preferred treatment B was observed. Okay, so he considered the experiment as what type? The first one is a binomial experiment. Here, this study stop in the first patient that we observed treatment B observed, then it is a negative binomial or geometric experiment. Negative binomial or geometric. Okay, so we have two different setup. If I'm choosing as the investigator, I actually choose the first one. The second one, the logic is a bit different. Okay, so let's calculate the likelihood functions under the first investigator and the second investigator. Okay, so the likelihood function according to the first investigator okay, we have a likelihood of P given X, which is just 1 here. Here P is defined as the probability that treatment B is preferred. Okay, so this means that X is only 1. So we have 6 patients, only one of them choose the B, or is it better, the second treatment, B treatment is preferred or better. So P to the 5, 1 minus P to the 1. So our likelihood like that. So our function based on P is here. Okay, so this part is just a constant. Okay, so let's consider the likelihood function according to the second investigator. Likelihood function according to the second investigator. We have P Alex here again. Let's say Y this time. Okay. So his setup is Y again 1, because his setup is this one shows us the probability that treatment B is chosen first. Okay, so we have P to the 5, geometric approach, P. Okay, so without considering the constant part, basically these two likelihood functions are proportional to each other. Although the setup, their experimental setup is totally different, investigator 1 and 2, then their likelihood is proportional to each other. Using the principle, likelihood principle, we can say that the results related to P that we'll observe will be exactly the same under the investigations of these two investigators. Okay? So this means that by the likelihood principle, we can say that the result that we will get will be the same. The likelihood functions of both investigators are proportional implying that by the likelihood principle let us to do that, they should or they will provide, they should reach the same conclusion. Okay. I believe you understand what is the likelihood principle after considering this example. Okay, so sometimes it's better to represent our likelihood function graphically. You know, graphical representations are much with the graphical representations we can understand the whole structure of the functions or the real phenomena better. So again, by plotting the likelihood function, we can understand its behavior much more easily. So plotting the likelihood function. So let's say we have considered 10 observations. So let's these are hypothetical ones. Hypothetical study in which we have 10 patients are followed for a fixed time period at the end of which 4 of them die. Okay, then what is the likelihood of this? So we have 10 patients, okay, and 4 of them died. If we can consider this experiment as a binomial experiment, then we can define the likelihood function. So the likelihood function is given by, it's a function of P, the success probability, number of patients dying, the proportion, 1 minus P to the 6. Okay, so this likelihood function is proportional to P to the 4, 1 minus P to the 6. So this part is just the constant part, right? Then let's say for different p-values we can calculate this likelihood, and then we can see which p-value is more likely to observe using this sample. Okay, so the likelihood of p equals 0.5 is calculated as 9.77 10 to the 4 minus 4. And the likelihood where p equals to 0.1 calculated as 5.31 times this one. Okay, now for different p values we can calculate this likelihood, and then the likelihood when we look at the plot of this function at the end, so we will see that. So we have a likelihood for different p-values. So we will observe that we will have this type of shape. Okay, so this is the most likely value and it's observed at 0.4. Okay, so this is the most likely value. So the maximum likelihood value. So now we have to look at the values, okay, here, and for different values 0.0, 0.1, 0.2, 0.3, 0.5, 0.6, 0.7, so it will go like that, and then for each value we will observe some specific quantities, let's say 0.0002. okay, so by this way it's easy to see the most likely value. Okay, so this is the most likely value of P. For this sample, actually. So what we observe here, most likely value of P when we observe X equals to 4. Okay? When X equals to 5, we will have a different behavior. When X equals to 2, we will have a different behavior. Okay, so the absolute values of likelihoods here is very tiny, as you can see, we have very tiny numbers. So the relative values of likelihood for different values of p are more interesting for us actually. And in more in most cases we are using the for computational convenience, we work with the log likelihood function, and they exactly has the same behavior. So in most cases, for computational ease, and actually to be able to explain likelihood function better, convenience, we work with the log likelihood. So the information that we will get regarding the unknown parameter will be the same with the log likelihood function. Okay, so we will use L theta, which is ln L theta x. Okay, so in most calculations, we will use not the log likelihood, the likelihood function, but we will use the log likelihood function. Then the R calculations are much more easier, and the result regarding the estimation of theta will be exactly the same. Because when we consider the, let's look at the plot of these two likelihood functions. So let's say we observe it like that, and we observe the maximum value as theta had here, okay? So this is the maximum value. So if we use log likelihood function instead of regular likelihood function, ln theta, so we will have the different numbers and different behaviors, but we will observe the maximum value at the same theta had value, okay? So instead of, because of that, and our calculations are much more easier when we use, when we take the logarithm, because if you look at, if you consider the probability density function of many statistical distributions like normal, we have e to the something in gamma, in chi-square, in exponential, in viable distribution, we have e to the some form. So when we take the ln of these, and also most of the PDFs in multiplication form, when we take the ln, we will return our problem to the summation most of the time. And then when we take the ln, the exponent terms disappears. So the most calculations are much more easier when we have when we use log likelihood function. Okay, then. So we understand what is likelihood function, what is the meaning of likelihood function. We understand the likelihood principle, I believe. And actually for different values of sample points, we can get different likelihood values. So then our point is, when we have a sample, so based on my given sample, what is the most likely value of an estimator? So we need to decide on this one. And then we have to choose this, the most likely value as the estimator for the parameter. Okay, and this will give us the maximum likelihood estimator. So this is the basic idea behind the maximum likelihood estimation technique. Okay, so maximum likelihood estimation, MLE. Okay, so maximum likelihood principle of estimation is to choose as the estimate of theta, okay, so let me write this. So the maximum likelihood principle of estimation is to choose as the estimate of theta for a given set of data sample that value for which the observed set of data is most likely to occur. Okay, so the maximum likelihood estimation actually gives us to choose an estimate for theta or an estimator of theta before selecting the data. But here we, for a given sample, we are finding the maximum likelihood estimation. So choose the estimate of theta for a given set of data, for a given sample, that the value for which the observed set of data is most likely to occur. Okay, so we have the data, we already observed that. So which theta value maximize the likelihood actually for this given sample? We need to find this. MLEs give the parameter values. Estimates of the parameter values. For which the observed sample is the most likely to have been generated. Okay, so this is the basic idea of the maximum likelihood estimation technique. So we want to find where this maximum likelihood function is getting maximized for a given sample. Okay, under the parameter space. So theta hat, which is the maximum likelihood estimator of theta, gives this one. So which value of theta maximize the likelihood function for a given sample? Likelihood of the given sample. Okay, so this is the optimization problem. So we want to find the maximum value of the likelihood function, where this the function is getting maximum for theta for a given sample. Okay, so this is an optimization problem. So since this is an optimization problem, we try to find the maximum point which theta hat value maximizes this function. We try to find it. Most of the case, we are using differentiation techniques, but sometimes we are using different techniques also. By using inspection, we can get results sometimes. So often, MLE can be obtained by differentiation. Okay, so we get the derivative of theta equated to zero and get theta hat. But here, you know, instead of likelihood function, we usually prefer to use L theta. Okay, so we have to be sure that our likelihood function is maximized. When this is maximized, basically we need to check the score that we obtain, theta hat value, maximizes the likelihood function, where theta equals to theta hat. So we have a concave up shape or concave down shape. When we have a concave down shape, we have a maximum point. So we have to check the second derivative as negative. So under this condition, our theta hat is the MLE of theta. Okay, so let's write the procedure to find the MLE. First, define the likelihood function. L theta. And then often it's easier to work with log likelihood. Okay, then when applicable, differentiate, if you can differentiate the likelihood function, differentiate ln theta with respect to theta, and then equate it to zero, then solve for parameter theta. Theta, obtain theta out. But you have to be sure that this is a global maximum or not. So check whether it is a maximizer or it gives us a global maximum. So this is mainly the problem in a maximum likelihood estimation. It is local maximum or global maximum. To understand that is much more important. Let me stop here and I will continue the next time how to calculate the maximum likelihood estimate, or maybe in another slide.